Hello everyone. So welcome to the session on Pelton wheel or Pelton turbine. So just to remind you that we have solved problems on impact of jets, and we have seen impact of jets on moving plate and stationary plate, and also seen series of vanes, etc. So now that we have solved all these problems and learned to draw the velocity triangles, we will now apply it to the real scenario, that is application level, which is our turbines and pumps. So fifth module, rest of the part is about different kinds of turbines, and one such turbine is Pelton wheel. So before moving into the details of Pelton wheel or Pelton turbine, we will discuss some of the general things, that is what is an hydraulic machine. So hydraulic machine is nothing which is a machine which converts hydraulic energy into mechanical energy, which can further be converted into electrical energy. So those machines which convert hydraulic energy into mechanical energy are called turbines. And how are these turbines different from pumps? So in a pump, pump is also a hydraulic machine, but here mechanical energy is converted into hydraulic energy, that is just the reverse of turbines. So in this module, we shall study the turbines like Pelton turbine, Franz turbine, Kaplan turbine. And in the sixth module, we have study on pumps, that is mainly centrifugal and reciprocating pumps. So coming to turbine, as I have already discussed, is a hydraulic machine where hydraulic energy, or the energy processed by the water, is converted into mechanical energy. So this mechanical energy can be used in running electrical generators or shaft of the which is coupled to the shaft of the turbine. And this mechanical energy can later be converted into electrical energy. Thus we have the working of hydroelectric power and all. So before moving into the Pelton turbine, the turbines are classified according to the type of energy available at the inlet of the turbine. So according to the type of energy, turbines can broadly be classified as impulse and reaction turbine. So impulse turbine is having only kinetic energy, if the inlet of the turbine has both kinetic as well as pressure energy, that is known as a reaction turbine. And again, according to the direction of flow through the runner, what is runner and all those things we will discuss later, we are classifying again turbines into tangential flow, radial flow, axial flow, mixed flow turbines. And according to the inlet at the head at the inlet of the turbine, high head turbine, medium head turbine, or low head turbine. And according to a specific speed, again, low specific speed, medium specific speed, and high specific speed. So now we come to the first kind of turbine, that is the Pelton wheel or Pelton turbine. So what is a Pelton turbine? It is basically a tangential flow impulse turbine. And here, as it is an impulse turbine, pressure energy of water is converted into kinetic energy in the form of high speed water jet. And here the jet strikes the wheel tangentially, then hence it is called tangential flow impulse turbine. And it is also known as, sometimes it is also called Pelton wheel. It is named after L.A. Pelton, who was an American engineer. So this is the schematic diagram of a Pelton turbine, which shows all the parts, and also from this working of the turbine can also be explained. So as you can see, it has a penstock, a spear, and at the end of the spear there is a nozzle, and from the nozzle jet of water is ejected, and buckets or the vanes are placed inside the runner. You can see, you can now see what is a runner, and all those buckets are arranged around the circumference of the runner. And there is a brake nozzle. We will discuss the use of brake nozzle in the coming session. And all these are put inside a casing. So this basically shows the parts of a Pelton turbine. Now basically the Pelton turbine has four main parts, that is nozzle and flow regulating arrangement, and runner and buckets, casing and braking jet. First, nozzle and flow regulating arrangement, which consists of the penstock, nozzle, spear, etc. So water from the source is transferred to the penstock to which nozzle is provided. So the function of the nozzle is to generate high speed water jet. And to control the water jet from the nozzle, a movable needle spear is arranged inside the nozzle. So that spear regulates the amount of water that has to be ejected. So the spear will move backward and forward in axial direction depending upon the flow regulations that is required. And when it is moved forward, flow will reduce and or it can be stopped. And when it is moved backwards, more amount of water will flow, hence the flow will increase. Now you can see what is a runner. The figure here shows that of a runner, and buckets arranged around the circumference of that runner. So runner is basically circular in shape, on the periphery of which a number of buckets are mounted with equal spacing between them. Buckets are usually mounted on either double hemispherical or double ellipsoidal shape. A dividing wall called splitter is provided for each bucket, which separates the bucket into two halves. That is, inside that bucket, if you view inside the bucket, it has a separating wall or two compartments. The buckets are generally made of cast iron or stainless steel or bronze depending upon the head of the inlet of the turbine. Now the third main part is the casing. The whole arrangement of runner and the buckets, inlet, braking jet are covered by a casing. Casing as such doesn't have any hydraulic action, but again, if you are putting it inside a casing, the splashing of water can be avoided. And also it helps the water to discharge to the tail race. Now the fourth important part is the braking jet or the braking nozzle. Braking jet is used to stop the running of the wheel when it is not working. That is, it provides a counter energy or counter pressure so that the bucket will not be rotating. The wheel will not be rotating. This situation arises when the nozzle inlet is closed with the help of spear, and the water jet is stopped into the buckets. But due to inertia, we know that the runner will continue to revolve, and so to stop this, a brake nozzle is provided. Brake nozzle directs the jet of the water on the back of the bucket to stop the wheel. The jet directed by the brake nozzle is called braking jet. Now coming to the working of the Pelton turbine, which is very simple. Water is transferred from the high head source through a long conduit called penstock. So penstock is basically a large huge pipe through which water is flowing from a high head. Nozzle arrangement at the end of the penstock helps the water to accelerate, and it flows out as a high speed jet. So as soon as nozzle, there will be a decrease in area. So decrease in area means the velocity will increase, or it will come out as high speed jet with high velocity and discharge at atmospheric pressure. And this high energy will hit the splitter of the buckets, which will distribute the jets into two halves of the buckets, and the wheel starts rotating. So as the wheel starts rotating, the kinetic energy of the jet is reduced when it hits the bucket, and also due to spherical shape, the directed jet will change its direction and takes a U-turn and fall into the tail race. Tail race is the last or the bottom part of the turbine into which the remaining water is directed. So this is an image of a water jet striking the Pelton wheel buckets. So generally, some of the technical details are, in general, the inlet angle of the jet is between 1 degree to 3rd degree. After hitting the buckets, the jet deflected angle is between 165 degree to 170 degree. You already know what is an angle of deflection and all. We have already seen that in impact of jets. Water collected in tail race should not submerge the Pelton wheel in any case. To generate more power, two Pelton wheels can be arranged to a single shaft, or two jet can be directed at a time to a single Pelton wheel. Now coming to the design aspects of Pelton wheel. These points are important. When we solve our problems, we will understand it more, we'll understand it better. So first one is velocity of the jet. Then we have another velocity, which is called velocity of the wheel. An angle of deflection of the jet, mean diameter of the wheel, jet ratio, bucket dimensions, number of jets, and number of buckets. All these we have equations. We will see one by one. So velocity of the jet at inlet, V1 is given by CV into root 2 GH. We are already familiar with this equation. That is the equation, well, to find out the equation of velocity. CV, as you know, is a coefficient of velocity, which will be between 0.98 or 0.99. And H is the net head of the turbine. So velocity of the wheel or the runner velocity is given by U. That is phi into root 2 GH. That is phi is the speed ratio, which is between 0.43 to 0.48. And angle of deflection is usually taken as 165 degree if anything otherwise is mentioned in the problem. Mean diameter, we have the equation U is equal to pi dn by 60. From that you can easily find the diameter. Mean diameter is represented by capital D. And jet ratio, it is nothing but the ratio of pitch diameter to the diameter of the jet. Pitch diameter is capital D, and diameter of jet, that is water jet, is small d. So jet ratio is commonly defined by, denoted by M, and M is equal to capital D by small d. It usually lies between 11 to 16. However, in most cases, it is taken as 12. So next one is bucket dimensions. So it is designed in such a way that breadth should be 3 to 4 times the diameter of the jet. Length should be 2 to 3 times the diameter of the jet, and thickness should be 0.8 to 1.2 times the diameter of the jet. So we'll see that when we solve some of the problems. And this is an image showing the bucket, Pelton wheel bucket. As you can see that there are two compartments inside that bucket, which is separated by a wall. So it will better direct the flow of the water. And number of jet, it is obtained by dividing the total flow rate through the turbine by the rate of water through a single jet. Generally, number of jets are limited to 2 in case of vertical runner and 6 in the case of horizontal runner. And how to get the number of jets? Number of jet equation is, we are denoting it by Z. 15 plus, Z equal to 15 plus capital D by 2D, or which is again equal to 15 plus 0.5, D by D is M, jet ratio M. So these are some of the equations, or when we design a Pelton wheel, all these factors, all these terms should be considered.